That just showed me the reason why I had that dream, and all the questions I was still pondering about that dream. The Lord made it clear when we were studying the book of Revelation, I think 19 and 20 on Friday night, about the mystery of the Lord.
17 and 18.
17 and 18. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, by a show of hand, if the Lord shows you the things that are defiling you, let me see your hand up. Huh? Let me see your hand up. If he shows you defilements, the things that defile you, let me see your hand up. How about you stand up, stand up, stand up? If he shows you what is defiling you, that's the purpose of the fast. Hallelujah. And if you didn't fast, go and fast and ask the Lord to show you the things that are defiling you. Because whatever is defiling you will keep you from being blessed here on earth and will keep you from heaven. Hallelujah. Now all of us, and I'm sure all of you that are family, most of you who are here for the 21 days, I want you to lift up your hands and say, Father. Everybody now on your feet, say, Father. Everybody in the church, on your feet and pray. This is very important. Say, my
father,
I do not want to meet him.
I do not want to meet him.
I don't want to meet the rapture.
I don't want to meet him.
I don't want to be here.
I don't want to be here.
With the Antichrist.
With the Antichrist.
I want to reign.
I want to reign.
My father, it is not too late to
show me
the things that Satan has deposited in my life to divide me and keep me from hell. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Even if you are very strong, pray. Anything that is defying my mind, that keep me from the action, or keep me from heaven, my father, seriously show me. It doesn't matter how terrible it looks, I want to see it, I want to remove it from my life. Pray. Pray. Father, we thank you for that testimony. We cover that testimony with the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. You are blessed. Who's next? I think it's Pastor. Not too long. Pastors, don't stop talking.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And
then that is when he ran away now, he tried to show me that I will see. He said, I cannot see anything. You will see what you want me to see. I pass you that case. This is me. When he come back, God was in control. And here I come, the rich window. I see all the around the road, excellent. But we are not excellent. Anyway, God was in control. And then, on the second day, for last fasting, God saw me in a dream. There is a plant field, which is very plant of seed. And then he showed me only elder women who plant in that field. And then I know how he can do it. But it's a big field. But is waiting for harvest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I give God glory.
Amen.
That after fasting, it is not immediate that we can relax. God showed me that we need to harvest soul. Hallelujah. Not only the result, but of the fasting. We need to take care. All the people must be come to the house of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because of time, this man is many. I end up
here.
God bless you, Pastor. We come with our testimony with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. We have to harvest souls. That is one of the reasons why God purified us, so we can be effective. So that the evil can run away from us when they see us, and we can harvest the souls into the kingdom of God. Clap for the Lord.
Amen. Then people ask me, what have you done? I said, I don't know. I So I received my wife from praise in the name of last night. I believe it is a physical and in the spirit and for all of us. Pray the name of people's name Jesus as a voice.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One of the dreams that show you defilement, please listen, I mentioned that during the fast, is that when you find yourself in toilets that are dirty, immediately God shows you that it means you defiled. And that Satan knows the secret of defilement. He knows that God is very holy. And so he puts little things in our lives that can defile us. So anytime you have dreams of defilement, please take them very serious. You find yourself walking around in dirty places or eating in places where you should not eat, or you know, maybe somebody is spitting on you, or you find your clothes are stained, or you are wearing rags, or you are walking around naked. Those dreams are showing that your soul is defiled and you need to go into fasting immediately. Praise the Lord. Alright. We cover that testimony with the blood of Jesus. Whatever your reward is, whether it's from the president of this nation or from God Almighty, you will never miss your reward in Jesus' name. Say, I will not miss my reward.
I will not miss my reward.
In the name of Jesus.
Name.
Remember, we spoke about reward also. Huh? One of the things that the Lord did in Revelation 21 was to judge people and to give them according to their reward them according to their works. And he keeps repeating it in chapter 22. He says, I come quickly. Look at it. Look at Revelation 22, verse 12. Everybody really wants to go. Behold, I come quickly and my reward is with me. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands, two hands, and say,
My Father.
Let me not miss my reward.
In
the mighty name of Jesus. Whether in this world or in eternity, my reward shall be intact. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord. I would say no testimonies, but I will just
two. Okay, thank you.
Okay, it was under the meaning of the class. My sister Mary, we were reading that scriptures about the churches. And that evening you told us, go back and pray, seek the Lord and find out what kind of a church are you. So I really went on my knees and prayed and cried, and the Lord did tell me what kind of a church it is. So I give thanks to the Lord, and I really appreciate also the teaching about defilement, because sometimes we may take it that we are okay, but it's not that we are okay. And it was a very good experience, and for me to learn what it is that defiles me. I give glory to the Lord. Then the other thing is, when we came here to pray, I mean, Bishop was saying, yeah, tell them they are all praying without faith. I was thinking, we are praying without faith, we are not believing that what we are asking for is going to give it to us. I really was very touched by that. I went back home, I prayed. I don't know what time I slept, but during the prayer time, I had a vision, and I saw the Lord. He was dressed like a shepherd with a staff. And he said, that was at the end of my prayer, because I was really crying out to him. And I just was so, like, in awe of him. I cried, I said, thank you, Lord, you are coming. I just started praising the Lord. And I just want to say that in this fast time, got to know the Lord, fear him. I really sought him, and I found him.
You found it. Come on. If you found the Lord during this fast, shout hallelujah. One of the jobs of Mystery Babylon, the woman in Revelation 17, is to fool you that you're a Christian. Hallelujah. It's to put defilement, it's to put false religion, false Christ in people. And so make sure that you seek the Lord and find Him. Hallelujah. Just to mention what she said about faith, look at Hebrews 11 verse 6. Hebrews 11, that's another important correction that the Lord came to make during the fast. Hebrews 11 verse 6 says, but without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he that cometh to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. Amen? And what the Lord said to me to tell those of us who are fasting, say, tell them, how can they be fasting for 21 days without believing that I'm going to answer? A lot of you pray, but you don't believe that God is going to do it. Hallelujah. And if you fast for 100 days or 100 years, and there is no faith, this scripture says you will never please God. Hallelujah. So make sure you work on your faith. And I remember I told you, I read to you 1 Corinthians 12, verse 9, that faith is one of the gifts of the Spirit. Hallelujah. You have saving faith. Everybody has saving faith. Everybody sitting here today, it's because you believe that Jesus is your Savior. But God wants you to have faith for everything you ask for. Hallelujah. Amen. So you have to really pray concerning your faith. And I think we mentioned that when you pray in tongues, it purifies your faith. Jude verse 20. And when you pray in tongues, it purifies your faith. You don't have time to doubt. You don't have time to fear. And so you should pray often in tongues. Hallelujah. Amen. Everybody lift up your hands. Say, Lord, I believe you.
Lord, I believe you.
Please increase my faith. Maybe they are not here, they are just looking at you. I say, lift up your hands and pray.
Thank you. as far as I could. So I thank the Lord for revealing His way to me, and also for Him, for me, to fear Him. Amen. And Bishop also said another time, it's one thing to know the way, and it's one thing to do it. So I pray that God will help me to fear Him and do His way. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. I want you, church, to please note that Proverbs 1:7. Let's read it together. Look at it. One, two, go. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. The fool says, no doubt. And I think it's one of the points of teaching during the convention. I mean, during the fasting. Amen. That foolish people don't listen to instruction. Hallelujah. I pray that you will not be a fool in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Alright.
Thank you. And the last one. Yesterday when I was doing my quiet time, I was praising the Lord, reading Psalm 92. And when I got to the verse 10, then the Holy Spirit led me to shout. I will read it. But my body will be exalted like a wild ox. I have been anointed with fresh oil.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So when the Holy Spirit made me to shout, I was just in His presence, crying. I was just crying in His presence. And then the Lord started to reveal to me that you came here in Namibia because I anointed you to come to Christ of Ministries. I enabled you to come so that I teach you the way, I revive you, so that even when you go home, all the things that you have learned here in Namibia in Christ of Ministries, you don't keep them to yourself, but you are going to preach others. No, I'm not the one now. But in my case, I'll be teaching to the parents and also laying the foundation of Jesus Christ on the children.
What is the job start? What do you do about that? The Lord says, I have anointed you. It's with fresh oil.
Yes, and
what are you doing about
it? And the Lord was revealing to me that since I came here to Namibia, all the circumstances, all the situations that I was in, you are giving me the grace to endure because you anointed me, because you are with me. So you are downloading of all of the instances when things, when you just had a temptation, but you are saying, because I anointed you, because I never some other time, because I will come to just find the way to fight it and settle the world to find the reason. But some people outside that group who visit us, they walk my car and say, she is mad. How can she worship like that? So God was revealing to me that because I anointed you, if you don't give up, you will endure. I gave you the grace to persevere. So I thank the Lord for that deep revelation in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah. If the Lord anointed you with fresh oil during this fast, wave your hands and thank Him. You don't need old oil. A lot of people are walking around with the oil of 2014, 2013, 2015. You need a new anointing. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for that new anointing. We give you all the praise. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Now one thing that struck me as I was talking is that our testimony is a summary of the anchor we were given this year. The Lord says, look at our anchor for this year, Psalm 25, quickly, from verse 4 to 5. Let's read it. Everybody, let's read it. I said unto the fools, heal not foolishly, and to the wicked, lift not up their horn. Lift not up your horn on high, speak not with a sick neck. Verse 10, go to verse 10.
hallelujah, that foolishness is removed from our life in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Let's clap for the Lord. Fools despise themselves. Fools just think to what they know, what they want. But the wise people fear God. And God expanded that to her. And also, God says, I have anointed you. When you fear God, He will anoint you with fresh oil. Hallelujah. When you do His will, God will always anoint you with the oil of gladness. And He will enable you to do His work. We give God the glory for all these testimonies. I know there are many other testimonies. Let's wave our hands and just thank God for the testimonies. I know He really worked during this fast. Even those of you that did not attend, we pray for you. We know that you saw Jesus.
Hallelujah. Father, we give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, all our testimonies are sealed. Shout hallelujah.
All right, can we look at the privilege that you take him now? Yeah, on the false Christ. We look at that. Somebody sent me this morning. Amen.
Just this morning. I don't even know why I opened my phone. I just opened it. I wanted to call my daughter. And then I saw this.
The room sitting down with the door closed when all of a sudden Jesus Christ appeared right inside that room. It was one on one, I mean face to face. Jesus said to me, "The devil will tempt you in my form. Be careful." I did not change anything from the exact word or language that Jesus Christ used. Let every soul hear this, as God and His Christ are my witnesses to this all-important message to the body of Christ. After saying this, the Lord Jesus Christ, who spoke to me, immediately turned into an identical tool to portray in practical terms what He meant that the devil will tempt the church in His name. I mean Jesus turned into two, and it was impossible to differentiate them except by the Holy Spirit. Jesus said that this is the end time final strategy of the devil against the church. There is danger now as the devil is deceiving people all over the world, disguising himself as Christ. And many are following him to hell without knowing because they are not careful but careless. Jesus warned that Satan will transform himself into an angel of light and his ministers into ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, 13 to 15. Heaven is disturbed that many Christians seem not to understand or take serious this very warning, and the result is telling on the church as Satan and his Antichrist ministers are celebrated today by blind Christians. Believers are not discerning, neither testing the spirits or proving all things, as commanded in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 21, and 1 John chapter 4, verse 1. Jesus Christ said in Matthew 24, "Take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many." Take note of the word many. Jesus warned that false Christs and false prophets shall arise and will use signs and wonders to deceive the very elect if care is not taken right before us. These things are happening, and the church, which is the last hope of mankind, seems to be so much asleep. Another gospel has taken over the churches outside the gospel the apostles preached. What will it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? The church must return to Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Christ has left many churches, and the Antichrist spirits have taken over. Some ministers preach grace as license for nonsense. Never had any apostle of Christ preached grace as an endorsement for sin. Grace is for godliness, not of godliness. Any message that does not discourage you from sin, warn you against hell, and prepare you for rapture in heaven is another gospel. A minister that is not preparing you for Christ's soon return with all the signs already fulfilled is working for the Antichrist, whose spirit is already here. The Antichrist ministers are already here, and many of them are being celebrated by foolish Christians. 1 John chapter 2, verse 18. Any minister that makes the narrow way broad is an Antichrist minister. You will know them by their fruits, says the Lord. They don't care about saving people from sin or their making heaven. Christ's coming is not their concern. These are the days of another Jesus and another gospel. So please, beware. This message is coming from me, Witness Ken Paul, a living witness who Christ appeared to one on one to deliver it in the authority of Jesus Christ, who is my own living witness. Hell is real, and heaven is real. Where will you spend eternity? It will be over any moment from now. Repent from your sin and truly make Jesus the Lord of your life. I want to be with you in heaven when Christ will come to take us home. Things are falling apart because the devil has disguised himself as Jesus and is deceiving the church. Stay rapture ready and heaven worthy. God bless you. If you would like to receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior,
hallelujah. Just this morning,
I have got the message.
I had thought, maybe the enemy was trying to stop me from showing the video that I preached in 1993 to you. And I'm going to show it now. It's just about an hour. Any church you go to, and the emphasis is not at this end time.
Their emphasis is not on taking you to heaven with me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You need to flee because your soul is in danger. If the emphasis is on poverty, on prosperity, on whatever, you need to flee fast. Praise the Lord. That's why I showed you this clearly. And one thing you need to pray for is discernment.
Many Christians have, like, we pray a lot for that during this fast. Many Christians don't have eyes to see.
Hallelujah. You need to have eyes that see at this same time. Praise God. I want you to just look at that video for a while, and then we'll go to the end and pray.
Help me to pray. Help me to fast. Help me to get ready for action.
Help me to study the Bible. Give me understanding. Help me to go into that book of Revelation and study it and see the destruction that is coming on this world that is already here. In Jesus' name. Amen.
You may be seated. Now, you may think it's old school, and that is where Christ God started from. Clap for Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Forget about the passions, about the old school, about the thing, just listen to the message. Amen? Amen. What did I say?
I said, I don't know what you made this man. and make the heart of every man and every woman be sensitive now to the working of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I bind and seal, I bind every spirit of carelessness. I bind every deafness in the spirit, every blindness in the spirit. I rebuke the forces of darkness of any man to be oblivious to the things of God. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, speak to your people. Speak to your people. Speak to your people.
Praise the Lord.
So God is releasing the secrets that you need to know. Praise the Lord. Now, verse 2.
With whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of our fornication. Now, it's not possible for the kings of the earth to sleep with one woman. This is not literal fornication. Amen? Are you hearing me? It is spiritual. Amen? Hallelujah. Please open your eyes and wake up. Amen? Everyone say it is spiritual. It is spiritual fornication, but it is also a spirit behind every fornication. It's a spirit. Hallelujah. It's a spirit you should cut out of your life. Hallelujah. It is not possible for the kings of the earth to sleep with one woman, but this spirit has influenced all the kings of the earth with her spiritual fornication. It is not safe. And may also the inhabitants of the earth. Amen? The Ephesians said the kings of the earth and the people of the earth, they are under the control of this woman if they are not born again. That is how terrible she is. Verse 3. So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet colored beast, full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and ten horns. Remember, we have seen this beast before. Huh? It's the same beast. This beast is no one else than Satan himself. So this woman is supported by Satan. Hallelujah. She is sitting on Satan. She is supported. Satan is carrying her around. I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet colored beast full of names of blasphemy. The color that the beast is wearing this time is a beautiful color, but it's for evil. And then the names of blasphemy are on the beast. Okay. And the woman was arrayed, the woman also was dressed in purple and scarlet color, also beautiful colors. And she was decorated, she was decked with gold and precious stones and pearls. She has a golden cup in her hand, full of abominations of filthiness of her fornication. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. Now, every time you see spiritual harlotry, every time you see harlotry or fornication in this thing, it's talking about spiritual harlotry. Whether it is religious demons, whether it is idolatry, whether it is backsliding, that's why she has a cup full of all kinds of religion, full of all kinds of abomination, full of witchcraft, full of, shall we say, Islamic religion, or, look, let me tell you. Most people believe that this is the Catholic Church. I'm not going to hear that. If you are reading your Bible, and most people believe that this is the Catholic Church, if you don't look at the colors of the Catholics, those are the colors that their cardinals and their bishops like to wear, the purple and the scarlet and the gold. You know that when they are serving Holy Communion, just take that.